What's up, Internet? Welcome to 2021. And grabe yung 2020. Takot ka lumabas, may pandemic, may mga lockdowns. Takot ka, you know, for the safety of your family. You're worried about your livelihood. Ang daming anxieties. Ika nga ni Netflix, death to 2020. But even if last year is one of the years that we'd all like to forget, looking back on it, I realized that there were some tech lessons I picked up. Thanks 2020, dahil sa'yo, napulot ko yung mga tech lessons na to.
Ang video na to ay handog ni cdkoffers.com. Marami kang mahanap na iba't ibang uri ng software dito. May games, apps, activation codes for Windows 10. Check out our video on CDK Offers in the video description. Mabilis, mura, and syempre legit dito. Madali lang mag-order, search for the software you need, add to cart, check out, daan ka sa payment options nila, wala pa isang minuto, finished. May legit working CDK ka na sa software na pinili mo. Gamitin ang aming promo code para makakuha pa ng extra 20% discount sa purchase mo. Kung naghahanap ka ng mura, legit, and original software, check out cdkoffers.com.
Number one is how to stream. Pre-pandemic, uso na yung streaming. It became even more so during the pandemic. But I never learned how until nasa bahay na ako. Pag tinanong na ako ng mga customers na sapat na ba to for streaming, can I play this game with this CPU and stream it at the same time? Do I need a separate computer para mag-streaming? Yung mga tipong ganon. Masasagot ko na sila based on experience. So we started with 3 streams in September. Pwede magtanong, live from the shop and in the industry. So they've been fun to do, pero medyo stressful. Learning how to do everything, tapos palagi may technical issues kasi bulok yung internet sa atin. But basically, for streaming, on the software end, you just need OBS or Open Broadcast Software. There are variants of OBS, but they all stem from the original OBS. But basically, OBS is relatively easy to learn, and there are a lot of tutorials online about it. Yung maganda dito sa OBS, you don't actually need a very fast computer. Sobrang luma ng computer ko, i5-4690K with DDR3 RAM. Pero, na-stream ko pa rin yung FPS for a test stream. We've done multiple shows where maraming tao on screen. We have 4 people on screen for pwede magtanong. No problem naman with my OBS, with my old system. That's another thing. On the hardware side, actually streaming isn't that demanding. So you can stream a lot of games without worrying na you need a super high-end computer. So on the software end, OBS. On the hardware end, you don't really need super fast hardware. So, first lesson I learned from 2020. The second, also related to streaming, is na hindi mo kailangan bumili ng webcam. As you guys know, sobrang kuripot ko, ayoko gumastos, yung cellphone ko second hand, graphics cards ko second hand. So, I really try to get value for money from my devices. And when we started streaming, ayoko bumili ng webcam kasi bakit? Ang daming cameras. Namely, yung camera sa cellphone. So, there is software that allows you to use your phone as a webcam. The one I use is Droidcam for Android. Super okay yung Droidcam. Very easy to use. You don't really need to think about it. Tapos, reliable siya. And if you have a decent phone, like, yung sa akin, actually, sobrang luma na ng phone ko. OnePlus 5T. Pero ang ganda pa rin nung camera niya, and that shows on the streams. Usually, in very good light, the stream is very clear. At night, kapag, you know, naka-rely ka dun sa mga overhead lights, it's not as clear but still very worth it. Kahit yung mga webcams na mabili mo, hindi rin sila ganun kaganda in low-level light. So actually, your cellphone is probably the best bet, and it's free. If you're using Apple, iOS, may walang Droidcam, pero I use something called IPV Cam, I think. And you see that when I do live from the shop where we have 2 cameras, one on my face and the other like at table level, so you can see what kind of things I'm opening, I'm showing to the camera. So we have a 2-cam setup for live from the shop. Yung ayoko lang sa IPV cam is that there's a watermark. I haven't been able to find any other software sa Apple na parang Droidcam na libre tapos walang watermark. So as usual, mas mahirap gamitin yung Apple. As some of you know, I'm also an Android person. We got a lot of new hardware in the shop that we could play around with. Thanks to Asus, who lends us a lot of hardware, NZXT, ASRock. So a bunch of people have lent us different things. Yung pangatlong napulot ko from 2020 was that ang saya pala mag-game na naka-headset. And number one dito that we were able to play around with was the Asus ROG Delta headset. Ganda ng audio quality, and it was really, yun nga, sobrang immersive regardless of what game you were in. Dati, speakers ako all the time. I even had a setup before where apat na speakers, tapos yung dalawa sa likod. So I could have surround sound in front of me and behind me. Tapos, tuwang-tuwa ako nun when I was playing Rome Total War. If you've ever played that game, you can zoom in to your units and ganda nung reproduction ng sounds because you can hear the cavalry charging behind you. You can hear your men going, Principe! And things like that. And you can hear them rattling their shields. So I had a good time, you know, going around the map and hearing the sounds from in front and behind. But in my current setup, it's a bit harder to do. I only have space for front speakers. So na-miss ko talaga yung level of immersion that you can get from speakers behind and in front. But you can get that with a headset. So noong 2020, bumalik ako sa gaming using headsets. And for TV watching, I actually use a Sennheiser wireless headset. And I've used this also for my PC. So you don't need a gaming headset or even a headset from the usual PC brands. You can go with headsets from other brands if you want to try that out. It seems like a small thing, but to hear the level of detail, ang dami palang nawawala na detail, sound detail when you play with just speakers. And you pick that up when you use a headset. And it's also nice to shut out the world. I think that's something that we all looked for in 2020 na ang daming bad news sa 2020, ang daming nangyayari sa labas. And you just wanted to cocoon yourself in your own world. And headsets allow you to do that. Salamat din sa 2020 na bumalik ako sa gaming on a high refresh rate monitor. I've talked about this before in some other videos na dati hindi ako naniniwala sa high refresh rates. Parang inisip ko marketing hype lang yan. You know, 144Hz, 166Hz. But because of the lockdown, and yun nga, I've explained this in a past video, ninakaw ko yung isang monitor. Actually, itong monitor sa likod ko na pinahiram ni Asus. Ninakaw ko to from the shop, inuwi ko. Kasi wala namang gagamit sa shop, diba? Sayang lang naman. So tinakasan ko yung lockdown one time, tumakbo ako dito sa shop, kinuha ko to, inuwi ko. Ang saya pala maglaro on high refresh rates monitors. Yes, okay, I mean, the gamers in the audience are like, well, of course, duh, parang given na yun. But my experience before with high refresh rate monitors wasn't that particularly impressive. But with the Asus monitor, I really saw the light, kumbaga. I'm like, wow, parang ibang-iba to. Asus has lent me another monitor, the 27-incher. And I'm using it now as my primary monitor. Tas ang ganda. Ganda pala maglaro in 1440p. Ganda pala maglaro in higher refresh rates. So 2020 has brought back to me the sense of gaano ba kahalaga na maganda yung monitor mo. And napabayaan ko to. Parang nasanay lang ako sa mga 24 inches na, you know, parang it's like, oh, pwede na. 24 inches, 1080p, 60 or so hertz. But thanks to 2020 na may panahon ako para mag-gaming and sa mga companies na nagpahiram sa amin ng hardware, I can't go back. And so, itong primary monitor ko na Asus, when it comes time na kailangan ko ibalik sa kanila, I will get, sinasabi ko na, I will get another monitor na at least 27 inches na kaya mag-2K and kaya ng mga 144Hz because I can't go back. And the last thing I picked up from 2020 is that medyo maliit lang pala talaga yung power consumption ng computers. Yung kwento nito, because I was stuck at home, I wanted to stream our video files or yung mga video files na nakuha ko from before, like TV shows, movies, and things like that. I wanted to stream them to my TV. And so I used Plex for this, and madali lang i-set up yung Plex para siyang Netflix for your own video files. Libre siya. Pero yung thing dun, the PC needs to be on 24 hours. Hassle kasi kung naka-on siya, pero akit ka na sa kwarto mo, manunod ka 11 PM, wow, nasara na pala yung computer. Bababa ka pa kung nasan yung computer, i-on mo ulit. Hassle! So I decided to leave a computer on 24/7. Yan yung media server ko. It's an old computer. Nakalimutan ko na ano yung specs talaga niya, pero Black Edition ata siya na CPU. I'd have to check or something like that. It actually has a 1000W PSU. I mean, it's ridiculously overpowered to be a media server. Pero it was an old PC I had on hand. So basically, fully depreciated na yan. Libre na siya. Di ko na kailangan bumili ng iba pang components. So I turned that into a media server on 24/7. And napaisip ako, how much money am I burning? How much electricity is this guy consuming? How did I measure the power consumption? My friend Marvin, you know him from Pwede Magtanong, nasubukan na niya yung Lasco Eco Plug. So this is cheap, you can get it off Lazada, I think for like 325 pesos. And it's Wi-Fi enabled, so you plug the Lasco into the outlet and then you plug whatever it is you want to be measured. You set up the Wi-Fi connections and then you can now check on your phone ano yung consumption ng power of that particular appliance. So you configure the Wi-Fi settings and from there you can see in real time on your phone how much power that appliance is generating. So ito yung consumption ko in real time. That's 0.75 kilowatts for the entire day, and then I don't know if you can see the other text, but that's like amperes and kilowatts and things like that. So yung media server ko in 24 hours, it consumed only 2 to 2.3 kilowatts per 24 hours. So in one day, 2 to 2.3 kilowatts. Magkano yun? Yung isang kilowatt from Meralco right now is around 4 pesos and 10 cents. So mga less than 9 pesos yung dagdag sa electric bill ko per day because of the media server. So let's say it is 9 pesos. Let's round it up to 9 pesos times 30 days. That's an additional 270 pesos I'm spending kasi hindi ko na pinapatay yung media server. Naka-on yun 24/7. And so it really depends on your budget kung if that's something you want to save on or if that's something na, yeah, sige, pwede na kasi sobrang hassle nga bumaba, i-on, bumaba ulit para i-shutdown and things like that. It's 9 pesos a day you could be saving, but at the same time, it's 9 pesos that you can spend to make things less frustrating, make things more convenient for you. Pero natuwa talaga ako sa Lasco Eco Plug. Parang it's a really good buy. Linipat ko siya from the media server. Now it's tracking my main rig. So I want to see how much power it consumes on load when I'm playing FPS and things like that to get a better idea of how different computers use different amounts of power. Pero overall, nagulat ako na ganun kababa yung consumption ng media server. But to put it into perspective, wala masyadong ginagawa si media server. Yes, naka-on siya, hindi naka-sleep yung computer, hindi naka-hibernate. Pero it's really only running or it's really only performing when I'm asking it to serve up a video file, which isn't all the time. So I'll be monkeying around with the settings to see if we can get that power consumption even lower. Pero hindi ko yun masubukan kung di ako na-stuck sa bahay and gusto ko na may video on demand para sa mga video files ko. So I fell down that rabbit hole thanks to the lockdowns of 2020. So terrible year, but still some lessons to be learned. I hope everyone is safe and continues to be so in 2021. Konting kapit na lang. Hopefully the vaccines are around the corner. Things will go back to normal slowly. But you know, I'm a glass half full kind of guy, so I like to be optimistic. And so I tried to look back on 2020 and see ano ba mga napulot ko. And you know, actually there were some interesting stuff. I hope to learn more in 2021 and I hope you join me. Thanks for watching. And thank you to you guys who have joined our YouTube membership. There are some cool perks to joining, such as getting advance notice of incoming items and being able to reserve based on the items that are coming in. Shout out to our top fans, Asher Gape Anima Mundi, Mark Palanya, Christian Espinosa, John Ruben Ocha, and Deep Raishon. Thanks and stay safe.